You know what Angeal would say?
Genesis.
That's right, Genesis. Deadly, dreary, a simulation built far from reality. I am trapped in an artificial world filled with dinosaurs and must breach through the simulation gates in order to make it out alive. There's no red pill, blue pill situation here. It's just me. One life and the fabrication of dinosaur reality that stands in my way. But what makes Genesis so special? Well, let me tell you, this map has five biomes. The death-filled bog, the endwalking moon, a flaming volcanic region, an almost endless and frightening ocean. And you can't have ARK without the cold roof of the world. The objective, same as usual. Survive 100 days, evade death at every turn, gather the forces of Genesis, complete all the missions required, and challenge the AI Master Controller for freedom. I only have one life. If I die throughout any of this, it's done. That's it. It's over. Mission deaths don't count, though. I know. I'm cooked. Ladies and gentlemen, it's 100 days to go. The challenge awaits. A matrix-filled dinosaur world and our unyielding defiance. Time to initiate the sequence. In Genesis, we don't scratch our arms. Instead, HLNA gives us a PhD thesis statement on how not to die. I decided for the snow biome to embrace my forthcomings. Ran around a little bit. Found a glitch, gave me zero hexagons, and I had to teleport out of there because I wasn't running out of water, but health itself.
I am nearly dead. Maybe the north was not the best biome to teleport to. Oh god, oh man.
The ocean was going to serve as my initial safe haven. Why? Look around you. I am surrounded by water. And I am a thirsty man. I made my way to the manta race mission.
Wow, that's a lovely color. Oh my god, it's an electric eel.
Thank you. In Genesis, these missions are the only way to attain loot and hexagons. With these hexagons, I can buy supplies or materials from HLNA's built-in shop. Most of them are ripoffs. Finish the mission smoothly on all levels, gamma, beta, and alpha. I spent the entire day just surfing this. The loot was sus, but it gained me some good old levels and hexagons to buy up stuff from HLNA and create the raft. Buy now on Steam for only $7.99. I sailed like a pirate. I found a giant turtle. It's called a Megachelon or Chilion or Chili. It's beautiful. These glitches are supposed to give me 500 hexagons. But cap! When ARK'S glitches are actual glitches, there's a deep-seated level of irony planted in fixing these glitches.
Ironic.
There's nowhere else to go.
Is it possible to learn this power?
Get the hell off my boat, man! Needed to make an ocean platform, but the only way to do that is using the harvest of giant turtles.
I'm being shocked.
For that, a pickaxe was not going to suffice.
This is pretty terrible.
The raft was momentarily invaded by the giant Megachelon.
Come on! Oh my god, he's going to the wall. Wally.
Over the horizon was a giant turtle being assaulted by sharks. This was equivalent to underwater hood activities, so I had to seize this opportunity as Tyrone. Bad idea.
Oh my god! This was a bad move to keep! This was one of the worst ideas I had ever had. And it despawned. How did I do that?
Got the essentials up and running. I still yearned for the oceanic base though. I had it all. Stone, paste, wood. But no shell fragments. Curse you, giant turtles! underwater farming queue in 3, 2, 1.
I can't even hit that through a wall.
The day ended with some arrow creation in Mexico, wondering why half their cartels are empty. It was me, Austin. I felt the tingle of adventure creeping up my spine. Henceforth, I teleported to the cold north, courtesy of Freya Curry, which, unlike my chador at night, keeps me very warm. I found an opus, butchered it. Twilight fell and I couldn't see a damn thing. The torch guided my path. To hell. Oh! I managed to escape the crazy tickle chicken, but it cost me my most important element. Pants! I was a pantless man.
I was. Oh! Monkey, please.
And I knew my purpose was tied to it.
Monkey!
I teleported back home with Monkey.
Shoosh!
Wally was viciously assaulted by the underwater cops of the sea, electric eels.
No way, right?
Who would have thought?
Not me.
But I had a berry collector. I was a happy man with a happy monkey.
I just want some rocks. They killed my... Oh my god. What? Huh?
Started day 4 with some underwater harvests and swam back to the raft to unravel my yields. I've become a true farmer. An underwater scuba diving farmer boy.
What?
Sailed through the night with red lighting. Felt ominous. Actually had a million narcotics on the way. I scolded Monkey for picking up too much fiber.
What the?
I teleported back into the snow region for God knows what again.
Teleport complete.
Bad idea.
Okay. Alright. Alright.
Yay. Since I lost my one and only friend, you don't count, Wally. I began taming another monkey. Called him Monkers. We went to the north to perhaps scout out a base location. Nothing fun happened there.
Oh my god, this ain't it. Huh? Oh no. Oh no, 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 no. No, 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 no. Whoa! Talk about speed.
Queued up the porting route and went northeast of the death-filled bog. Monkers and I jumped through every hoop, and I was certain of this platform to bear our primary presence. It had metal, crystals, was a safe platform with only one way up, and even some vegetarians. Remember when it took me 60 years to create a platform in Aberration? Yeah, I don't either. Put up that platform looking real nice, half of it visible, and the other half just a green aquarium. TP'd back to the east of the oceanic world to relocate everything into my newfound bog base.
Peace.
This was a horrible idea, you'll come to know why soon enough, but at the times, whatevs. After storing everything into Monkers, we made our way to the bog. Cautiously, we placed every footstep, but alas, to no avail. Sarco ambush.
Right. Once in life where either I live or Monkey does. Uh-oh. I gotta drop the metal. Monkey this way.
Monkers wasn't so lucky. More like dead. I made it to the platform and began placing down whatever the heck I had. Thirsting for vengeance, I killed the monsters that consumed Monkers, but this place was a safari of crocodiles. Endless. Spent half a sacred eternity looking for Monkers' death bag because he carried plenty of important materials, but my detective skills were not up to par. After quite literally spending the entire day snooping around, I found it. Rocked some metal, created a few legendary stone traps, and put it to the test.
What?
I needed a new berry collector anyway.
Boy! You, sir, will make a fine addition to the collection.
I had no idea how much narco berries these things were gonna need. Gave him some medjos and holy shit, realized how fast its torpor was going down. Rest of the day, I did some rope shenanigans and harvested some crystals. My friend awoke and I named it the hardest tame ever. Made a saddle, hopped on, and began the merry berry collection spree. Brought out Civilization, the Fabricator, and placed it within the greenery part of my base. I was never going to find that Fabricator ever again. My patchy rhinoceros thingy could release a gas that makes us invisible to nearby dinosaurs. Only problem is, he's so slow, what is even the point? We'd run a total of 10 feet before the walking crocodiles could just pounce on us again. So I put him to better use. Carrying metal for
He's
me.
He's a great carrier.
I thought I should put up a greenhouse together too, because why not? I'm a farmer boy, gotta get out of the way. I've always wanted to contribute to global warming. And so I did. Day ended with me putting in the pipes. This was a painful procedure. You'll see. Chose violence to clear up the area so I could safely plant my pipelines. Finished the pipeline, thankfully, and used a grappling hook to wrap up the Len San versus Ladder / Feud WrestleMania. I could climb up the base, but it would not let me go down?
What? Oh my god.
Was finally complete.
What in God's name is going on there?
Judged a bit.
Pathetic.
My search for a taint that could defend my life properly began. Peeked into hopefully what could be a dire bear or a wolf, but instead I found nothing.
Back to the middle.
A bear.
Horrible. Became a legitimized criminal as I stole cement and paste from beaver dams.
Here to report a crime.
Yeah.
An international war crime,
right?
Poor guys couldn't even keep up with an ISO certified legend in the run department. I live in the bog, for Christ's sake, y'all. Stop it. My next stop? The moon. I looked around and was instantly turned off by the flying machines of destruction invented purely to annoy the living hell out of me. Falling in the lunar biome means an auto-teleport back into one of those space rocks, so it's just a restart hole point. I feel like there's nothing of value here, so I went to another location of the lunar biome. It's empty. There's nothing here. Next up was the northeast of the snow biome to search for a new hope. I found a bear, trapped it in, and began the unholy ritual.
Sweet mother, send your child unto me for the sins of the
Noticing that the poor dire bear would die to my trank arrows, I needed to heal it up. So I murdered a little critter, dragged its corpse to the bear, and he munched. I mean, he munched. My HP went to hell, boy. Finally, man went down. Found two peaceful ovises just chilling. And I introduced them to being chilling and the world of pain.
I'm sorry.
Fed the bear, made the saddle, and onward my
warriors. Onward to victory.
Wanted to tame up a bronto, and my decision-making skills upgraded from horrible to absolutely detrimental in 3, 2, 1.
I worked really hard on this.
You have done that yourself.
Oh man.
I should fucking go. Just right now, I should fucking kill you, fucking go!
I don't know why I even live here. This place is literally hell. I can't do one thing without getting interrupted by the nation's first responders to see if I've had my daily dose of carnage yet. Well, fear not. It's only gonna get worse from here on out. Mother Nature!
Followed me here.
Why my base, bro? What did my base do to you? Cooked some meat to swallow in my despair. So I lost footage for day 10. But meet Thunder, the wolf, and SAS, our healing operative. Caught them both in the snow. Fortune truly does favor the fortunate, huh? Well, sadly, this is a tragedy. So tighten up them emotional belt, Shakespeare.
The series nearly came to an end right here.
Oh shit. God damn.
Twice.
Oh no. Man, I really can't get a break, can I?
Took Thunder out for a lovely spin. I thought I was invincible. Then reality hit me.
Whoa. Not thunder. Man, how do I keep doing this to myself? Lord above.
Thunder died. He's gone.
I'm sorry.
So now SAS would have to do. And he's pretty tanky though.
That's right.
I started the Dodo basketball game and matched up Gamma, Beta, and Alpha.
Yeah, I'll deal with that.
Come on, feet back. And that's the game.
Again, I ventured into the north, searching for a tickle chicken. I found a 125, trapped it, and went to work.
It doesn't make sense, but I'll tell you this.
Filled it with Mejos, Narcos, and I'm not a certified drug dealer yet.
Just kill it. Turn it off.
I spotted a 145.
Do it!
I ran out of Trank arrows, so right, I TP'd back to the bog base to attain more. When I came back to the cold roof, the 125 I had knocked out? She disappeared. Yeah, gone.
What?
But I still had the 145 in the trap waiting to be knocked out. So, all was not lost. Until a wild Yudi showed up and started squaring up against the trapped chicken. It was going to die. I fought that Yudi until one of our souls left the simulation. The Theri was too low to be knocked out by regular Trank arrows now. I needed darts.
What a misery trip, man.
Went home, made a sniper rifle, made some Trank darts, equipped them, TP'd back, and finally.
Oh my god. Ah, shit, here we go again. If those guys got a ball kicked on
the Theri was fully healed up. So I didn't need to do it anyways. I wanna die. Day 15 was Theri hell. I found another high level Theri Xenosaur. You must be thinking, Len San, just knock it out. I wish it was that easy, man. I went on a roller coaster of constant Theri aggression and abuse.
Oh my god.
Okay. SAS, come on.
I finally trapped it though.
Got him!
After knocking it out, I made my way to my first ever Theri tame. With him, I fought
my old enemy. Diablo.
Shut up, you damn ghost.
We made it back to our new awoken friend. Named one the Chicken Tickler and the other Stizzy. I know, I'm a genius. Was picking up the stone trap, but I was interrupted by him.
Oh man, that's not good.
We brawled up a mountain while Sizzy just watched. Finally, after slaying the wild beast, I cryoed Sizzy and the tickler both decided to unfortunately use right. My brain once again. Teleported east of the lunar biome to trap the 180 tech rex I saw earlier there. Arrived, midair A0 combat proceeded. The 180 Tech Rex disappeared. Round for it a little bit, wondering there's no way it could get off this moon rock until I heard roars somewhere not in sight. So being the ambitious man, I ghosted in. The Tech Rex had fallen underneath the world terrain somehow.
What?
Bro, this game jank. I thought I should put it out of its misery. I forgot the tickler was super low. To make matters worse, I started falling.
No. Where am I going?
Get back up and I quickly cry.
What is happening?
But I was too late for the tickler.
No, the tickler.
At this point, my sanity was diving. Every single one of my teams just dies, And when I try to tame a new one, yeah, it has to always bug out or disappear. I was done. But the world falling wasn't done with me.
What did I just hear?
How?
Tried disabling the creative mode, but it just wouldn't work. This is what I get. After two restarts, I managed to get back to base, and in a fit of rage, I decided to acquire vengeance by making that underground underworld tick 180 Rex mine. I've lost all patience, and I will do what I must. If the game take it away, I shall take it to me. I began the teleportation to tame that 180 Rex. I wanted to play it simple, to play it safe, but no. No, Genesis has to screw me over at every turn, huh? I swear on Genesis, I'ma do it. For some reason, my Trank arrows multiplied itself to thousands. Didn't notice initially, but I was going to have to drop all of them once I was done. I'm blinded by the light. After a century, there he was. Bingo.
Oh my god.
Happy with my new team, I threw away all the tranks. In pain? I zeroed the hell out of the moon, never to be seen in that horrific scene again. Or so I thought. Back in the bog, I felt truly invincible. No stupid little crocodile or raptor or bog law enforcer was going to stand between me and my quest for purifying the area.
Eat your food, man. Eat your food.
Remember that ascendant saddle I got from the Manta mission? Put that beautiful thing on Kinga, and now I had a squad. They're looking fire. Straight up, no cap.
Like you could, G.
Began getting the old Genesis generator running along with the wires. Placed enough outlets and the whole thing runs like a well-oiled single. It just runs well. Hid the electrical cables because I don't want people to judge my bass taste, even though it is absolute trash. Sorry, Dad. I was never an architect. Leveled up Kinga, gathered some metal. Smells like progress. For some reason, the lunar biome seemed to be the only biome that existed for me. But it's for a good cause. I needed electronics and oil. Why is it cold? The series almost ended again.
It's way too cold. I take it back.
Made it back home. Fed SAS since this man has quite the appetite. Oddly, the crystals I harvested near base have not grown back yet. Weird. Put Kinga in the Pokeball and moved to the east of the ocean. I began my search for a giant turtle to slay and fixate my oceanic base. You know what I'm killing it with. Okay. On day 18, target acquired.
I mean, this is a bit slow, but that's it? That's all I need?
I'm on a boat and it's going fast and rafted my way to the ideal spot, which I call my secondary home. Came back to the eastern island and teleported back home again. Hit up some rocks and made Bahamut gates for future purposes. I seem to be slowly furthering on the border of insanity.
Poseidon, look at me! Oh!
Yeah! Took what I needed and yeeted out of there. So I swam further along the coastal sides where I would be safe. And I would be able to make a perfect little base attached to the island. Place the first gates and the ocean platform itself. I'd love to live out here in the ocean, but metal is scarce, so is crystal. Hence, the bog. Yeah. Not like the resources near my base will never grow back, right? Right? Made Kinga carry some rocks underwater. Man was really working overtime. I had a crazy idea. Started the Mosa hunt.
The Mosa proposal.
Instantly, I get sucked into a whirlpool. Right beside my base.
Win! Guess that's a bit too late, huh? What's that over
there? I quickly realized this underwater Rex mission, it wasn't gonna work. Saw Mosa caught in a bubble though.
kinda cute back on the island. Godwood thatch, finished up them gates. Lured in that 145 shark I found from the depths of the abyss, and look at it. Wow.
Oh my god.
The tranking session was going quite good. Until... Huh? What? Depressed, I TP'd back to the bark and began hop, skip, and jump with Kinga. I needed a win for the day, boys. Escorting a frog throughout its journey to its family. Mission was a breeze and the loot was...
That sucks.
Went home making sad noises. Donated blood at the end to make myself feel like a good person. As day 20 began, I once again chose to display ruthless
aggression.
Sheesh.
I completed cheaper by the pack on Gamma with Sizzy and Kinga. Loot? It sucked. Went home, used SAS to heal up my dinosaurs and crafted out some trank darts. TP'd back to my ocean base and finally plugged in that gap that's wider than the space between my teeth. Felt quite good, actually. I found the 145 female megalodon, luckily, not too far off. And I lured it back in once again.
What if I load in a dart?
You can guess what the rest of the day looked like.
Can I shoot in your eyes? Does it hurt? No, I don't think I need it.
Summon Sizzy, we were going to take a little tour in the Arctic in search of mutton. Cause that's what sharks eat, right? Mutton. Even though they can't walk on land, they eat mutton. Goodbye, Obisom. In my endless search for another good therizinosaur, I found none. And instead decided to cull half their population.
This entire city must be purged.
Realizing I had almost done an entire victory lap around the edges of the snow biome, I went home. More defeat than victory. A genocide though. Aaron would be proud. Fed the megalodon, and once she rose, I named her
Fishy.
Finally, my underwater mission ventures could begin.
Cap! Totally cap! That means lie!
Yeah.
Wondering how I got here? Well, I searched the endless sea floors for another high-level shark. Found one, but it was at the edge of the oceanic map, and my shark pen was located in the middle. So the chicken chase began. I went through purgatory to bring this shark back to the base. I kept going back, losing aggro, fighting random things, but maybe after 2 concrete hours of freezing my balls off in the water, and my theory being abused, it was closing in.
Yeah.
I used my real estate knowledge to lure the fella at this point.
Love it. You're gonna love it. It's beautiful. It's got a magnificent view, a big entrance. And you'll ride it home. Just come in. Come on in. I'll even just bite. Take the bite. Yeah, just like that.
You're in. I was Michael Jacksoning.
Hey, that's
finally, it's down.
Wow.
Next day, I had exactly 2,300 fiber. Thanks, Sizzy. Thank you very much. Back to the bog base to queue up some daily order of a billion narcotics. I noticed the metal and crystals I harvested near base weren't growing back. It's been 15 days now or something. Drank all the soups I could and to the north. Although I came for some meat, I ended up grabbing a bear? Wait, that's not right. Needed a honey gatherer. It's okay. I went to town, killed the poor sheep, got the mutton, roamed the cold north till Windy woke up.
back to the ocean safe haven that I went to mark the true beginning of my underwater adventure.
Henceforth, you shall be known as...
Bait. Place the other two platforms to make my base seem spacious even though it was emptier than the Vatican City itself.
Empty!
I named the baby shark Little Fishy. We are 1/4 through the challenge, and I feel like it's been a bit slow. Chaotic, death-filled, many of my teams have suffered and died. If this was the medieval ages, they would call me the Len Plague. Jumped off my base and nearly ended the challenge again with great rhetoric ideas.
Oh my god.
Healing session was about as useful as my therapy. I got none. Felt bold today, so I took one Spy versus Spinal Gamma mission. This mission is a certificate of death if I am not careful. Followed its tiny footsteps, it still took a while. How does a spinal this big leave such small footnotes like this? Who designed this game?
Wasn't me.
Got it done though.
Got gloves though.
It's Gamma. What did I expect? Next up, I challenged the Bog Spider racing mission. Wrapped it up with a bow tie on Gamma, Beta, and Alpha.
I mean, it's all right.
Back to the Basha, stored up whatever I could, gave meat to SAS. His hunger is
the void.
Speaking of hunger, how am I any different from any of these animals? I'm eating raw too. Damn. Wow. Bridges had to be made soon. Can't go on like this, boy. You need help. I put up a grill to embrace the culinary arts of cooked meat.
They're fucking here!
Took Sizzy and farmed like a true carry all the way 40 minutes with the Battle Fury. The results? Look at it! I created about 4 Megalodon saddles and took SAS with me to the ocean. SAS was now part of my oceanic base. He watched me raise kids in the shark pen. Mandatory blood donation to signify my suffering citizenship of the Boglands. The healing continued. The Rock electrified Kinga underwater, but he got jobbed out. And I continued raising my little fishies.
I got a feeling.
In the middle of the day, I took to the Mosa proposal mission on Gamma with my pack of sharks all grown up. I had a lot of kids now. Hee hee. Making them fight wildlife. Hee hee. It worked out quite smoothly after delicately murdering everything else down there.
Oh my god. Can we take this big boy? Let's kill him.
Let's kill him!
Took the squad safe back home. Brought SAS to the oceanic life for a better view, a better purpose, a better life of slavery. To heal my shark squad, you peasant.
Oh my god! Triplets! I'm a lucky man.
The entirety of the next few days was dedicated to raising my shark squad.
Damn, that's a lot of sharks.
More blood donations, because I am a good person, right?
I thought you was a thug.
TP to the bog and search for SAS species, and luckily ran right into one.
All
right,
there's one.
Trapped, knocked, Fine. Served, went munching for food. He awoke to be called Queen Niffy.
From metastasis. Look at you.
Little base shenanigans continued as I realized the metals and crystals near our base will just never grow back.
The crystals not regrowing, nor the metal.
I don't know what sort of bug this is, or some kind of resource spawn issue, but I'm done. I am so done. I came here for resources, only to always TP back, fight my way through the Get Down Mr. President bog squad, and feel stranded with no resource. I made the decision to shift.
Really?
Forever. Where to? To the only metalless place I know, the ocean. At least I can TP there instantly. Compared to this pit of malice. Made a date on settle, and true to my words, I bailed to the ocean. But there, fatherhood duties awaited me.
What's up, you local fiends?
Oh, it has to be done. My naming senses started to reflect my sanity.
Little one.
Sizzler.
Suffice to say,
hitter.
Rapidly deteriorating, I roam the southern part of the bog looking for a bloodstalker. I know, my UI is bugged. It's getting to me too. I make my way through various tunnels. I start shooting down the ones I did not need or just could not tame because they were too high.
It's a 55.
I'd like a 55. Eventually, everything just started imprinting itself on my screen and glitching. Classic ARK. The entire next app was me trying to get this stalker's attention. But guess what? Senpai don't care about me. You're gonna deny he even exists, Senpai? I was convinced it wouldn't touch me. I began to TP out, and that's exactly when it pulled me.
Oh my god!
It kept picking me up, only to drop me halfway. How is this a thing? How am I supposed to tame this? Do I need a rocket ship? I was a bit tired of being dropped on my head by half-willing bloodstalkers, so I did what I was born to do best. Give up and leave. That's a lot of sharks, man. With the shark squad, I began the Alpha Mosa proposal. These things are super dangerous. All my megalodons could face certain death. But that means very little when just a few sharks can unwind the very fabric of the Mosa's health in mere seconds. Hunter 1, prey 0. Good on you. Took them all home for the healing therapy session. I left them alone for just a few minutes and more kids. It's like the basement of my cousin's wedding. Made a little ladder so I could climb back up to the island instead of doing an entire stupid rotation. I TP'd back to the bog and began the transfer. Stuffed plenty of things into Kinga and many more into Sizzy. We were going to have to move everything. Armors, saddles, structures, creatures, even the goddamn greenhouse. We were running a smooth operation until...
What in? No! Not off the cliff! Not off the cliff! Wait, where's King Rex?
This made things a bit more complicated. Hey. But everybody made it, and so did everything else.
These giant claws.
Manicure.
Hold on. Right
on top. After another little healing session, back to the bog I went and took all I could.
Bravo 6. Going dark.
Including half the greenhouse. Lamau.
Lamau.
After the successful transfer on the island attached to my base in the ocean, I started planting civilization and welcoming the roots of my success.
Really?
The S structures pulling item method was a huge MVP. Without it, I don't think this would be here at all. After many more item pulls, transfers, and placements, the cables appeared.
No, it can't be. Not the cable!
Even started a little greenhouse again to grow my crops.
Oh no, he's back.
A forge was next up, along with leveling all my sharks as well as saddling them. Healing. Saw a bubbly Mosa floating to the surface. Coincidentally, I honestly went searching for a Tuso. And I found one.
Oh my god!
I went up for some oxygen, bought one black pearl mistakenly,
the black pearl,
and lamaed my way back to the bottom without stopping to think, what am I doing? A Tuso needs at least 50 black pearls in one instance to be tamed well.
Ma'am.
But I forgot the shop only gives me one.
Yes.
I realized this a bit too
Feast
late.
On his soul.
Back up I went and caved into ripping myself off.
This is gonna be pricey.
Went down and tried to tame it again, but it wasn't hungry, so...
Alright. Part the two.
Third time's the charm.
Oh my god. Alright, this is it. This is it. Come on. Yeah, baby!
Named him
Wee.
Took Wee back home merrily. This day, I swamped into the boglands again for another try at the Bloodstalkers. I traveled roads and dwelled through caves yet again.
What
Lo
the?
And behold, it was happening to me again.
Ooh.
How did Leech get on me?
Picks me up halfway and tries to drop me to my death. But this time, oh, this time. All right.
But is it against the law?
I was ready.
All you gotta do is hook me.
Finally.
Okay. Yes, that's what I'm talking about, boy.
Yeah, look on that blood, boy.
Well, it's tame. But are you feeling all right?
Hey, I saw this coming.
I'm feeling great. Let's name you the Cupcake.
Invisible Swinging. Yes, my favorite.
I went on to hopefully taming a second one, another 95 female. Not bad, I guess.
We got this.
It's not supposed to drop me, but single player settings are sus.
But I only have one parachute remaining, so you better not drop me, you better not drop me.
My stalkers were nowhere near in sight. I had no parachutes. This was dangerous. If I'm picked up by stray stalkers in the skies, I could drop to my death and it could all end right here. I searched on cautiously for at least one of my stalkers.
What? Huh?
My luck ran apparent in the weirdest way possible. There was a level 15 Bloodstalker camping on a wall, and it pulled me in.
I had just about enough blood packs, and I got another spider. Wait. Well, hello.
Guess every farmer has his day in the field. Got to finding my Bloodstalkers.
It's the Cupcake!
Wee! Buddy, what the hell?
You never know your fate in these boglands.
No. Oh my god! Really? No.
Landed on an entire metal site.
Look at that. All right. Well, it's one of those moments.
Back to the ocean where I pulled most of the metal out of my dinosaurs, if you can even call them that anymore.
You were just an animal.
My base looked like I was having the weirdest rave party in the history of 12,000 BC.
We're looking good.
Finally grew courageous and ready to challenge the AI master of the ocean biome. With my entire squad of 19 sharks and one girl Tuso, Motor awaited in the depths. First up, Gamma. Initially, we kill his minions and he appears.
There we go. Oh my god, it's a big one.
His minions reappear and we beat the electrical eel poles up again and repeat this process until...
Goodbye.
That was pretty easy, but it's just Gamma. I queued up Beta instantly, knowing this was going to pose more of a challenge. This time, everyone was taking a lot more damage, and Motor wasn't as easy to take down. After some lightning struggles and pulls of the whirlpool vortexes, we managed to get it done.
I killed him.
We pulled ourselves out of the deep and dark cave and swam home. I leveled up everybody, and therapy began again.
How do you feel?
Horrible.
Day 38 began with me breathing harder than Darth Vader. Took the Cupcake and made it swim, baby. That's right. These spiders are speed incarnate. Water, overland, in the skies. Chad. Began another bottlenose blitz race mission. Wrapped it up swiftly on Gamma, Beta,
and this.
While finishing up Alpha, this notification appeared.
It was killed by a Mosasaur.
What?
Hi.
Alpha Motor awaited.
Squid Sun! Mite kureyo! Everyone's in.
Motor was out and lethal with his lightning. We fought Tuso tooth and tentacles. This time the whirlpools were sucking in all my megalodons.
Why, Motor, why?
I knew this was a bad omen to come. I could see my shark squad visibly falling low, many of them bleeding. Wounds appeared and my HP too was shrinking due to the lightning.
Boy.
The whirlpool truly was a menace. It pulled all the sharks in and spun them to the corners, wasting precious time. And time was not being kind to my HP at all.
We're so close.
No.
Whirlpool.
We did it.
Oh, we did it. Oh my God.
Oh, we did it, baby. We did it.
Oh,
we went home. Straight home, Chief. Nothing but home. After my success, I thought to myself, Len-san, how's about we go get some magmasaur eggs?
Good idea.
To the scorching volcanic biome, I embarked. Relied on my old 2020 memory to find the volcanic cave. I can't even remember what I had for breakfast. Huh.
There it is. I see it.
Not bad. Worked out.
Ooh.
I was cautious. The volcano erupts from time to time, so being within it when it explodes is instant death. And the end of the series. Everything was so hostile. It's as if the magmasaurs knew what was coming to steal their children. Like someone put up a notice, this man's coming.
I'm coming.
Can't I just kidnap kids in peace these days? Thought dispatching Kinga to demolish the magmasaurs would give me free reign to steal their eggs. Unfortunately, it wasn't just magmasaurs down there.
A goddamn rock golem. These things are damn near invulnerable. What in the?
This was bad for my Rex. It would take too long for my Rex to fight it out, and he would die in the lava he stayed down there. This was a death sentence for Kinga. I had to think quick. I weighed my options, and I realized the best course of action was to run.
Kinga, that's enough. Big bad man coming for you. Holy shit, you're a beast.
The rock golem defended their eggs more fiercer than any magmasaur I've seen.
Bro, what was he? The rock father or something?
I had enough of feuding with Dwayne Johnson.
It's cooking.
So I went to the other pit. I quickly stole before barely evading death.
Let's go. Let's go. Whoa, that was not it, Chief.
Oh. Conducted a high-level metal run to compensate for my level 100 egg. Kills. Once back on the island base, I chose to visit the bog. I truly wanted some carnos. They are my favorite dinosaurs on ARK, and I looked hard for them. Gave up after 30 minutes of purely flipping in the sky, Young Bucks would be proud, and conducted another metal run. TB back home and pulled it all in the forge, boy. Back to the bog again for the endless search. Found a 145.
What?
Crafted all I could. Tried to tame a something Archimond.
Tremors and despair. Doom has come to this.
A monkey.
But it wasn't a shoulder mount. So. Life is still cruel. Back to the boglands again, for it must be done.
What?
On the way, I found a 135 female carno. Genesis is being too kind to me today. Something is sus. Backed up the cupcake only to be assaulted.
Oh shit. This ain't it.
Lured it in only for it to be stuck in a natural life setting. This matrix is being overly nice to me. Now I'm getting suspicious.
You like that?
But I took the chance and I knocked it straight out of the ballpark. Packed up my shizzle and went to the drizzle. Lured the girl in and...
Bruh, be my friend, please. I'ma name this one Shelly.
I stared at the beautiful tracker, taming a level 45 Bronto. Why, you are in for a surprise, boy. Had to go get mutton for the carnal pair, so snow biome, here I come. Woohoo! Shook. Destroyed him, and he'd be back. My speculation was right. Happiness in the simulation is just like everything else. Fleeting, fabricated. I switched to the tracking tab. The carnal pairs no longer existed. The Bronto no longer existed. When the world needed them the most, they vanished. Searched in desperation everywhere. But once more it fell on deaf ears and a futile quest. Feeling the pain of being abandoned, rigged, and mutinied against by Genesis, I got on a hill and just quit for the day. Next day, I inspected the unrendered stalker.
You looking nice.
I became a friendly neighborhood bog man for a while and began taming a new Bronto. Level 50, but he'll do. Launched myself way up into the Sky Islands and got a frick ton of honey, baby.
That's enough honey for now.
Perhaps a venture into the moon awaited. But first, I must fulfill my photographic endeavor. Scoured across the lunar biome in search of a queen high-level Rex, and made a little mistake of falling into the stars.
No. Listen, I want you to know, Cupcake.
Yeah, Houston, we have problem.
I'll find you somewhere out there. Hey, we're back in it.
Went surfing into the lunar caves to find Mr. Crab so I could harvest his soul for organic polymer.
That's beautiful.
Finally, a crab in the cave of a floating rock. Started taming a gas bag while I was at it. A pair. Tracking bar served true. Teleported back home to the ocean, repaired my crossbow, got kibble from my 40k loot, which was trash. Got a lot of milk though. Began my teepee, and I realized that the gas bags that I knocked out, oh yeah, you guessed it, nope, nuh-uh, gone, vanished, into the void. Teleported to the wrong section of the moon and discovered the perfect 180 female Rex.
Okay. Plan change.
Went back home, got the legendary stone trap, wasn't gonna let this Rex fall through the world, lured the Rex in while being unable to cryo the cupcake, but fortunately, somehow the Rex kept missing. Sus, but I'll take it. I managed to cryo the cupcake and began the knockout procedures and lost my mind. Right.
How's it gonna feel then, girl? Yay, girl.
No running here. Let me talk to you.
1 eternity later.
This one. Woo! Stacked her with the kibble and soon enough, her name was Queen Rexe. Right. Slay Queen.
Giant.
Remember the reason why I tamed that Bronto? Brother. Holy Lord. Oh my God.
This is business.
Hey. Oh my holy God.
Was homebound with the teleportation and pulled thousands of crystals and rocks into the fabricator and smithy. I was never going to need crystals ever again. Did Kinga and Queen Rexy have a child? Ladies and gentlemen, we got them. I made about 40 wooden ceilings to finally add floors to my base. Cause I'm a man of substance. I really floored my base there. Talk to me!
Very nice place, look at the sky. Okay, that sucked.
Finally made my greenhouse actually sustainable enough to grow crops. Went to the snow biome, slayed some penguins. Yas, queen, yas. You must be thinking, Len-san, is there no easier way to attain polymer? Well, from my point of view,
the Jedi are evil.
Got the poly, came home, and made what Genesis intended for me truly, the egg incubator.
There we
Boy,
go.
With this, I can hatch eggs. No problemo. Sorry, ACs. Your time is up.
My time is now.
With my Magmasaur and Rex eggs incubating, I TP'd to the lunar biome once again. Oh no, what could go wrong? Swinged over to another cave only to hear Mr. Krabs make noises underneath the cave itself. No wonder all these caves are empty. All the carcinos are just spawning underneath the terrain itself. The falling began. Coming soon to theaters near you.
Hold up.
A quick relog fix of cupcake? No!
Oh, no way.
I was too careless leaving him in the moon. Of course, nothing good happens here. Back at base, I stored the poly, put down a cooking pot, and stored more eggs inside the incubator. Floored up whatever I could, I hatched the eggs, cute little tech rexes everywhere, and a baby magma who I named Mag. Me. I'm surrounded by children. Bought 700 paste from the store and collected a whole ton of berries. Put the chemistry bench to work by making more narcotics. Coach, sub me in. Gathered the sharks out of the pan and initiated who hid the squid alpha. Jumped right into hardcore territory. We got it done and had zero casualties. Granted, a lot of sharks were low and the loot sucked. Home, heal, and once again, into the fray! Finished who hit the squid beta, because alpha was tougher. I hate it when my sharks get stuck in air bubbles. There's no way for them to latch free, unless I hop on and squish it. On day 47, I returned to the lunar biome once again. Because let's be real, I'm a masochist at this point. But it was more importantly to collect my old gas bag out of one of the caves. And back home we went. More healing therapy and the snow biome for more metal acquisitions. Damn, I hate metal music now. My industrial forge was forging, boy. Fired up the forces of nature and dwelled deeper with my shark squad to do more underwater missions.
This is the end for you, my master.
Finished that easily. Then executed the white whale in gamma and beta successfully. The alpha white whale also succumbed to our reality bending damage sharks. Ray, zero.
Hey, that's pretty good.
Once the whale series was over, Locked and Loaded was up next. This was going to be easy. Finished up the Loch Ness Monster on Gamma quite easily. Ran it back on Beta 2 and put the cherry on top. Half my squad was getting lost in the bubbles and the whirlwinds and the vortexes all around the sea. But I still pushed forth. I was feeling quite confident. The Loch Ness Monster on Alpha was our next course meal.
It's, oh, that was a disaster.
They might have underestimated the Loch Ness Monster a tiny little. Yeah, it whooped my ass and eliminated half my squad. I took Wee back home and realized due to the evaporation of my shark squad and my decision-making skills are progressively getting worse. I had to get this series done before I hit rock bottom. Good thing I got most of the hard underwater missions out of the way.
That's pretty true.
I salute you, shark squad. I'll never forget most of ya. Texas grew up without imprints, cause I forgot! Many of my shark squad was scattered across the ocean. Maybe I'll find them one day. Like,
treasure.
Took a trip to the bar, found a level 85 carno at this point. Something had to satiate my disappointment from the underwater trauma. Tamed him rather easily and called him Little Hands Frank. Unfortunately, tragedy struck again.
Are you serious?
Can't have Len San being happy now, can we? I was left without any Bloodstalkers. I looked around with Sizzy, but all the stalkers were quite high. Not enough blood packs for it.
Who grabbed me? Oh my god. Well, don't mind if you do. Yes. Nice color. It's kind of cute. This is gonna hurt. How'd I miss?
How am I missing? This is not real. This is a simulation. This can't be real.
No. He's got a point.
Swung around the bog a little bit, taking in the view. It's a cold and ruthless world of chaos down there. Might as well get some peace in while it lasts. Just for the sake of it, knocked out a level 50 Carno and tamed it. I was desperate. My stalker decided to bail?
What? I'm sorry, huh? What was the idea? How am I supposed to harvest that?
He was enthralled by the wall, I suppose. Snow biome was my next direction. Made my way to the peak of the summit and began saber salmon racing. Finished it easily on gamma, beta, and alpha was next to impossible, so I gave up.
How's this meant to be? No, we ain't doing this, chief.
Checked the mission logs and I had 31 missions done. 19 more and I could challenge the AI Master. Halfway through this challenge, I almost froze to death yet again. Eggs were being illuminated by the Keeper of the Light inside the incubator, and I finally had enough of stone trap, so I got a harpoon gun. Somebody called Peter. Popped open the entire Rex baby cavalry, and my naming sense kept getting worse.
Yay. Baby, chill.
No problemo. Placed down the feeding crow so nothing starves to death ever again. Ran into hide and seek missions, but instead I got swirled and twirled.
How does this make sense?
Gamma. I took a stroll around the seafloor near the terrariums. And guess what I found? A high level 2 Sono Caparino.
Somehow.
No way. No, not in the whirlpool. Not in the whirlpool. Oh my god.
Thought throwing my theory up would help. It didn't work. I used Sizzy as bait this time, and it worked.
Are we stuck? What is this? Alright, there we go. At long last.
I took at long last home to mate with Wee. As I made the Tussos mate, I realized the Carno pair I had was visibly hurting my eyes with their low levels. I judged them. Their penance, death.
I'm sorry, kids. Yep.
Can't have a low level favorite dinosaur. I took at long last after he finished laying his eggs, and I completed hide and seek on beta. Man, finding those things are a pain.
I can't move.
Back on the platforms, my Rex army began to rise up.
Rise up, Argent Crusaders! The hour of justice has come!
What is this? How come you all have the same goddamn color?
Raising all these kids, this was going to take a little bit of time.
Huh?
While I waited for the kids to grow up and graduate college, I commenced a few missions.
Fish sticks is that? There it is. Stop stacking up eggs.
What a forgiving race.
Just another day at the office.
At home, I became an ample furry. Wait. That's not what I meant. Found a 125U Tyrannosaurus. I had to. The beast awoke from the netted trap and killed my only remaining Bloodstalker.
No!
I threw out Sizzy to fight him. Bad idea. The roar forced my dino to go into a state of confusion.
This is not good.
Sizzy ran right off a cliff.
Not off the cliff.
Izzy had fallen to fall damage. All this and a stupid avalanche in this horrific place, freezing to death, the challenge almost came to an end.
Oh god. Take cover! Holy mother! Taking cover! God. my god. Mate! We gotta get out of here.
Thanks to Magmi, I barely survived. But I lost my best friend. Sizzy. I'll always remember you, man. I ventured into the cold north with only vengeance staring into my soul. I found a level 100 Yuti, picking on some poor creature in the corner.
It's no your place, boy.
Good. Goodbye.
And I called her TURBEAR.
TURBEAR.
Let's do this.
Come on, no! Oh! It's a PT. No way, right? Okay, bye, Iko. Oof. This is his bug. I'm surprised this man, he made it home to his family. You're welcome. Goodbye! Farewell!
Look who I found!
BOYA!
Yo, where are we going with this? We got 100 days to finish. Let's go back. As I returned on day 68, night was falling, and the time was nigh. It's time to wrap up this entire Genesis run. We're quite early, but I'm content. The required missions were done. I did 59 missions across all biomes. We're not gonna talk about the lunar. But now, I face the AI Master Controller. I made certain everything was prepared, set, and destined myself for nothing short but victory. Water jars, medical brews, soups, drugs, shotgun ammo, armor of all sorts. We were prepping up the apocalypse, boy. We cooking here.
Because it's gonna be delicious.
I've done this years ago on official, but it was with a group of people. Can I do it alone and finish this journey at long last without facing death? I've come so far. Time to find out. The sun rose and dawn broke through I initiated the final test sequence with my army of Rexes just looking at me. How the boss fight works is quite simple. You kill dino avatars that spawn, they drop keys, I pick up the keys, place them in the codebreaker, and move on to the next area. At this point, I could become a lockpick dude. This seemed simple enough and I was having a blast, but in this final phase, things get hectic. Giggers and Reapers were everywhere, and I ran with all my might not to get munched up by those and relay whatever keys I can to the Codebreaker and finish the AI Master when he's vulnerable. A million drones were stacking up on me too. This became quite annoying because the reload session took about half a year. Death was not far off, in fact, closer than I'd like. My Rexes were somehow crumbling. I knew I had to move fast. This fight was getting intense, but I had a lot more left in the tank. Everything was still going my way. Until. Other than the insanity of being ugly. I got ARK'd. Again. Mid boss fight. Man, I awoke. Depressed. In the regions of my base, looking at the literal sea of empty stashes. Not even my brother's thick stash matched this sight. I could even hear my corpse reloading the shotgun endlessly. Even in death, I had defied, but I was defeated. To lose like this, it isn't fair. And we know ARK. It's actually a square sandbox game. Wow, huh? Either way, I now have to build up an army from the ground up and pray that the glitch does not make its return. I was gutted. Little to my knowledge and favor though, the next few boss fight attempts were the average day of me walking through scorched earth while the floor was glitch-a-mania, brother. Instead of going to the lunar biome and shooting myself in the foot, why not honor my fallen best friend Stizzy and recruit his line of species? The cold north was freezing, but my will to find a high-level theory was unshakable. Plus, I've been here a million times. I got what I wished for. Netted a 140 male theory, but out of the bushes came out another high-level mate rushing to its defense. Hold up, mama. I had to lure them both down a pit, and a long, strenuous activity followed. Gated them, netted them, tranked them, one by one. I needed to venture home to acquire my kibble, and I feared the worst. So you know what? A little investigation. TP'd home, I turned on the tracker to investigate my paranoia. And that's why. They were falling through the world until no longer. Man, I was pissed off. I can't take such disrespect to my face twice. Call the doctor, call the cops, call the codex, call it all. Call the commands. I need answers. I did what I had to do, fairly, with the same level. It felt like justice to me. But Len San, isn't that cheating? Was it cheating when I glitched out and lost everything in the boss fight? Was it cheating that my two high-level therizinosaurs just fell through the world because I took a vacation trip to the ocean? No, it's not about what's right anymore.
It's about what's fair!
A new line was going to be made. A new order to rule the day and the seas, even though they can't swim. I was going to need a lot of edgecakes. A lot of them. Day 70 and the ritual was same. Made them, crack open the eggs, give them care, feed them, and... He's asleep, huh? Okay. I should stop messing with my single player settings. Seriously, I need to stop. Visited the boglands for some sap, needed it desperately for the veggie cakes. Went back home and father-daughter Therry time began. Going to an AAA meeting after this. Took my grown-up Therry for a trial attempt at the Aloe and Goodbye Gamma run in the volcanic region. It did splendid. This place is basilisk-filled. Reminds me of... Oh yeah. Tough times. Once you kill these basilisks, they turn into deflated air balloons. Thank you. Further down the line of Day 72, I hatched a bunch of theories straight from their ancestry line, embraced fatherhood as all these tickle chickens were truly my sons and daughters. How did I level these theories, you ask? Simple. I knew those Rex eggs would come in handy. Your trial of life is over. Thanks for coming. Damn, I should shotgun children more often. Hello and goodbye, Beta was funky. They pushed me and my squad down a mountain, and we fought up the mountain too, like a real Dragon Ball Z fight. But in the end, there could only be one victor.
Look what the cat dragged in.
I returned home just in time for therapy. Back to the dinosaur child murdering routine, I go. I'm a convict. What does it mean, Jimmy? What does it all mean? What are we doing, Jimmy? We're doing this again. I was storing a good amount of veggie cakes. This is a goddamn bakery now. I could feel it in the air. The time was once again drawing nigh. The barriers of Genesis 1 was going to meet its final breach. A May. Once again, I readied myself for the final test. Stored 10 veggie cakes in each Terry. This will allow them to heal up mid-fight. And drank all the soup I got. I brought even more water this time because I'm such a thirsty boy. All was going well. Same old keys, same old relay, same old run. And the final phase was once again in the palm of my hands. This time, there was no glitch to blame. No intervention of ARK'S either. Bad placement, electric lasers, and pure failure.
Yikes.
Back to false reality, and it was a painful gaze, I tell you. My sanity darkened. It wasn't a glitch that stopped me, it was myself. I was gonna need some protagonist, main level character energy right here, but this was hard, man. This was hard, Jimmy. This was hard. Stored all the veggie cakes in the fridge, and I was slightly glad I had two backup theories, but some part of my soul told me I thought I'd never need them again. But here we are, huh? Ah, shit!
Here we go again.
Fatherhood was one thing, but having all your kids from two different dinosaur species go extinct in two boss fights just to raise them back up all over again was a toll my soul was not familiar with. I'm quite certain the asylum would most certainly want a patient of my caliber. I could do well with them. I did all I could. Raise, care, prepare, and watch away. They grow up so fast, thankfully. Same old boring process all over again. Hours of just raising them. Still breeding, still raising, instilled with fatherhood. Wait a minute, Dad! Raising more kids than I'll ever have in the future. The entire day of day 77 was just me healing, filling meat so SAS and Queen Niffy could heal again. It was the harvest of the century in a day. Average dinosaur child murdering routine quota was met for leveling. At the very edge of day 77, here I was yet again. I set up a gravestone dedicated to all the dinosaurs I got killed. I spoke entanglement of their souls. Boys, I know I failed you. I know you guys died to glitches, or me just failing, or just dying to random dino avatars right out of a Cybertron movie. But I'm here to set the record straight. Today, I will not fail. Today, I will liberate your souls. Today, I will avenge your fallen attempt. Boys, this one is for you. Filled the Therizinosaurs with cake, looked up at the sky, praying to the Lord, and again, it began.
Don't keep those keys. Feed them in.
Halfway through the fight, again, I got ARK'd. My army insta-deleted. Again. Oh my god, I couldn't take this anymore. How? Why is this happening to me? I just want to finish this boss fight in peace and rest. Let me go. This is turning out to be a Linkin Park song, ain't it?
I don't know why.
Speechless. Honestly, purely, I was just speechless. We are on day 83. But it didn't matter anymore. If you are reveling in my torment right now, know that you are not a good person. Don't talk to me, criminal. Knowing that Genesis was not being fair to me in no capacity or form, I decided to do a little bit of time traveling.
Saraba atairaren. Hallelujah! Chance!
I went back in time, baby. Here we are. I cooked up some cactus broth and resolved to using an assault rifle to pack some heat on those drones. One final prayer to the Lord. I will tolerate no failure, no compromise, no more revives, resets, or reruns. This was it. Here we go.
Everything we do prepared us for this. Gotta beat those corrupted actors.
The phases seemed to last for a while now. I was slow. But I was cautious. But at the back of my head, I knew if I was going to be arced again, nothing could save me. So I threw caution to the wind and I ran like Eugene Bolt was being chased by cops on a police helicopter. Worked my way to the final arena and readied myself. About shock therapy, huh? One final key run, and this was it. A shoeless man running the destiny. And before you know it, I made it.
Yes!
Ladies and gentlemen, we got it. See you around, kid.
Simulation, but we're free. Bugger! The corruption's here too. Apparently it followed us from the simulation. But that's impossible. We might be the only ones awake. So let's get geared up and deal with the corruption before it spreads. It says here, tech suit for emergency use only. This definitely qualifies. Now that you aren't so squishy, we should figure out which part of the colony ship we're in. If we just... Oh, that's not good at all. Well,